Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Happy Wednesday. Listen, it's time to bless the Lord. So get yourself some praising room and let's lift up our God together. If he's been good to you, go ahead and type in the comment section, God's been good. And then let's bless him real big together. Come on. Give me the glory. glorify you. We choose to lift up the mighty name of Jesus. We choose to bless you and to praise you, our true and living God. So we say,
you, Lord, you are worthy.
Nobody but you, Lord.
No one can worship you for me.
For all the things,
you've done for me.
Too many to count, Lord, and no one, Lord.
No one can worship you for me.
So with hearts of gratitude and thanksgiving, we say,
all of my worship
will receive.
All of my worship.
Withholding nothing, Lord, we give you
all of my worship.
What a privilege to come boldly before the throne of grace.
give it to you.
For the whole family? Fall Fest is coming. Join us on the campus of World Harvest Church, September 19th, noon to 8 p.m. Bring your family and invite your friends for tons of carnival rides, games, a Ferris wheel, music, and the best food trucks Columbus has to offer. We can't wait to celebrate with you and your family. That's Sunday, September 19th, noon to 8 p.m. at World Harvest Church. For more information, visit whc.life.
Listen, if you know prayer changes things, shout amen. Type amen. Well, listen, we're putting that prayer line number on the screen right now, and we have people 24/7 standing by to agree with you in faith. We're ready to lean in for that breakthrough with you. Now, listen, you're joining us tonight, and you're a first-timer. We're so glad. However you're joining us, YouTube, social media, online, that you're with us, we have a very special gift from our pastor that we want to get to you. If you just get in contact with us through that information there on your screen, drop us that email address, and we will get that gift to you. Well, God bless you again. Thank you for being with us. Don't forget, hit that subscribe button if you're watching YouTube so you don't miss any of the new content that we put up all the time to be a blessing to you. Well, listen, now it's time to put some word on it. If you're ready for a word, shout yeah, type yeah, and help us welcome our pastor, Dr. Rod Parsley.
Come on, if you love Pastor Chris Deegan and these wonderful Valor Christian College world changers that he is raising up, tell us who that young man is, Pastor Chris.
Come here, man of God. This is Sterano McKenzie, all the way from
Abaco, Bahamas.
Abaco. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So Abaco had a tremendous hurricane.
Yes, sir.
How many years ago?
About 2 years ago.
About 2 years ago.
Yes, sir.
And we had been going to Abaco,
yes,
Valor Christian College, for several years,
sir.
And we were ministering on Abaco Island.
I've seen you there.
Pardon?
I've seen Miss Ashton there.
You met Miss Ashton there?
I haven't met her, but I see.
Well, run up here, Miss Ashton. Everybody, welcome the student pastor at Valor Christian College, the School of the Spirit, where world changers are made. And so we kept going there,
yes,
because there was an area called Peas and Mud, or Mud and Peas. Peas and Mud,
yes, sir.
Which were refugee children.
Yes, sir.
Not from the Bahamas. Look at this. There you are, Blair. I didn't even know that they had that.
Yeah.
Look at that young lady with that one on her right wrist. Everybody shout, it's all about the one. And so these were some of the ones,
yes,
that, is that Narolyn over there, Miss Ashton?
Yes, sir. Yes.
There is Narolyn, who just got promoted, woo, I might add, on our staff, on our team,
yes,
here at the Harv. She worked in my office for several years,
yes, sir.
And but she was a student there.
She was.
Going to Abaco.
Yes, sir.
And now she's been promoted.
Yes.
I don't know. They were measuring in my office the other day.
Uh-huh.
I think they're about to move me out and move her in. She got such a promotion.
Yes.
We're so proud of her.
Yes.
But look at how beautiful that is. Now,
yeah,
for those of you at home, this island and this area of the island called Peas and Mud,
yes, sir,
these are not children from the Bahamas.
Right.
These are not children from the Bahamas. All of those children are refugees, orphaned from not this past one, but the one before Hurricane, right?
In 2012.
In 2012.
In Haiti.
In Haiti.
Yes, sir.
In 2012, it hit Haiti, and so the Bahamas said, bring us all these children. They're orphaned. They have no mother. They have no father. Everything they ever knew is gone. I think you ought to take 18 seconds and just thank God for how good he's been to you.
Hallelujah!
No, like how really, 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 really unbelievably good to you. But now watch this, because this is quite a story.
Yes.
So we would go back year after year,
yes,
and we would minister there. And
yes,
that's
sir,
where Ms. Ashton met,
yes,
Sterano.
Yes, sir.
How old were you then? Do you remember?
Had you graduated high school yet?
I had graduated high
school. You had graduated high school.
Yes.
And you lived on this island.
I did, yes, sir.
So here are these Haitian refugee, homeless, motherless, fatherless children who are being educated. And they're being cared for. And they're being ministered to. And they're being fed by believers. Not by the government. Let's thank God for the work of the Church of Jesus Christ around the world right now. So I can see some of our current students that are here tonight say, well, why don't we still go there? Well, because not long after that picture was taken, a hurricane hit Abaco. Now, the hurricane that hit Haiti was terrible, but the one that hit this island left 90% or more of the entire island gone. Now get ready. All of, thank you. Can we thank this media crew around here that has to put up with me and does amazing work? Amazing work. Look at that. There was nothing left. You couldn't fly in there. You couldn't get off a boat and go there. There was nothing. Now go back to my precious children. Go back to my precious children. I want to see them. There they are. None of those children made it. All of those children tonight are in heaven. All of them. His home was wiped out. His pastor's home was wiped out. People had nothing to eat. Devastated. And this young man got the spark of God in his belly to become a world changer. And he's not becoming one, my dear brother and sister. Sterano is a world changer. He could lead worship in 90% or more of the churches in America.
And Pastor, what's awesome about that story is the summer before the hurricane hit Abaco, Sterano decided to go back home. We were having summer internship. This was pre-COVID. We were having summer internship, but he got so personally inspired of the Holy Spirit with the spirit of evangelism as a result of being trained by Miss Deborah George.
Yeah, who's on her way.
Who's coming this Saturday.
This coming Saturday.
She's going to be here for a whole
week. The greatest personal evangelist I've ever known is back at the Harv and back at Valor Christian College.
So she's coming. We're going to go out into the
streets.
Who
else is coming?
Pastor Evans and Ashley Kariuki are coming.
The apostles of prayer are coming.
Also,
who else is coming?
Jabron Morton is coming back.
And his wife.
And his wife. They're going to lead worship Wednesday night with Pastor Chris and Harvest Music Live. They're going to lead worship in chapel on Thursday.
This is one of the greatest vocalists in America.
Yes.
And his lovely wife.
Yes.
And I saw on the list that they were going to be here. I said, what are they coming this week for, you know?
They wanted to
come. We've already got folks here. And they told you what?
They said, we want to come and be trained how to personally evangelize. So they're not coming they're not just coming to sing or worship or collect a paycheck.
No, they're
coming
not coming
to be trained
for a paycheck.
Yeah.
They're coming because it's all about the one.
Yes, sir.
And they are determined that they are going to learn how to win every unsaved person around them to Jesus Christ. After all, that is what we are all called to do.
So Sterano got so inspired of the Holy Spirit with that evangelistic.
So he went back.
Yes, he said, I'm not going to stay for summer internship. I have to go back home. I'm compelled to win the people of Abaco to Christ, not knowing that a few short months later, that hurricane would come sweeping through the island. And how many people did you personally win to the Lord
now,
just that summer?
Now, wait a minute. You've not been set in the office of the evangelist. So don't be evangelistically speaking now. You went back to your home island and you yourself began winning souls to Jesus. Like repenting,
yes, sir.
Conviction,
yes, sir.
And yes, how sir. Many souls did you bring into the kingdom of God and of his Christ during that summer internship?
It was 83.
83.
Yes!
No. I need everybody online. I need every single person online right now. Type in, praise God. It's about the one. Thank you for souls. Give us souls lest we die. Souls. Devil, your kingdom is coming down. The kingdom of our God and of his Christ is being exalted. And your assignment against the unsaved members of my family is canceled. I'm going to say it again. The assignment of hell against my unsaved family members is canceled. Me and my house shall be saved. I need everybody sharing right now. I need everybody typing right now. I need everybody commenting right now. It's all about the one. It's about souls, because the apex of all Christian endeavor is to place the jewel of a soul in the crown of our Savior, that the Lamb of God slain may receive the reward of his suffering. Let's thank God for a young man that in 2 months' time won nearly 100 souls on his own to Christ. Come on, give it up. You know what they don't know, Sterano? What they don't know is yesterday was Rosh Hashanah. Yesterday is what our Hebrew friends call the head of the year, the beginning of the year. Let me put it another way to you. It is New Year's right now. I'm not talking about a ball dropping in New York City over top of that hordes of helpless, hopeless, sinful, derelict, dying, diseased, destitute humanity. I'm talking about God said, you get a new beginning right now. Look at somebody say, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy Rosh Hashanah.
Happy
New Beginning. Your past is canceled. We are now in the 10 days of awe. At the end of those 10 days, we will celebrate the great day of atonement. Yom Kippur. The day of the atoning blood of Jesus Christ. But before we get there, we are in the second day of 10 days of awe. What are the 10 days of awe? The 10 days of awe are prescribed in God's word for repentance. Woo! I've been writing all day long in my new book, Revival. If everybody's shouting about revival, we got revival, we got revival. We don't even know what revival is. And the Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, write a book called Revival. If I'm chasing my spiritual father, the late great Leonard Ravenhill, and his powerfully anointed classic, Why Revival Tarries. God said it to me this way. We can have revival if.
That's it.
If. The blessings of God are conditional. What does that mean?
It means he will do this when and if you do that.
He will do this when and if you do that. You listen to your daddy really, really, really well.
I've been around a little
while. You've been around, you know, what are you now, 22? 22.
Bless you.
Yeah.
I'm 32.
Hallelujah. Well, I can't remember when I'm under the anointing. Amen. About natural things
I'll
like that.
I'll take 22.
Hallelujah. Sterano, we love you. Woo! Do you love this young warrior? Do you love this young warrior? Now, I'm going to have about 30 pastors clicking in there right now. When can he come? No, how many, what are you, a junior? Did you graduate second?
I've graduated.
You graduated second year.
Yes, sir.
That means he's got two more years.
Yes.
Then you can talk to me.
Yes.
Unless you want him to come for a weekend, I might let him come for a weekend.
Might.
I let Victoria go for a weekend, and who else? Who went with you? Logan? Logan went with you. I saw you preaching. I saw you throwing down Logan.
Yeah, yeah.
I saw you just tearing things up.
Amen.
I thought Pastor Delana and Miles Rutherford and Pastor Natalie and Brian Bolt were just going to go take a seat and let these world changers take over that three-day revival. It was inspirational and powerful. We love our world changers. And if you need information about how you can become a world changer right here on campus or online, no excuse. Fully accredited associate's degrees, fully accredited bachelor's degrees. You need to be in the school of the Spirit, where you don't just get head knowledge, you get spiritual impartation in Jesus' name. Now look, y'all can be seated. I don't know why you're standing around, but you can be seated. Listen, I want you to sign up. I don't know if we made this available to the world changers that are here tonight or not, but I want every person right now to listen very closely. Come in close. Come on. Come in real close. Tell the children, shh. Hold on. I want to give you 10, somebody shout, 10 in-depth teachings on the 10 days of awe. What you're supposed to be doing right now. It began yesterday, but you can get caught up right now. We are making it available online right now. Are you ready? It is a 10-day email series. Some of it is teaching, video, some of it is written. But if ever you needed to know what's going on right now in our world, it's at this very moment. What have we had? We had a hurricane called Ida that hit Louisiana and wreaked havoc all the way up the eastern seaboard, even crossing Ohio, spawning tornado after tornado, flood after flood after flood. There's another one approaching right now. So we had that. What else did we have? Oh, we had another earthquake hit Haiti. Bridge of Hope is there right now if you want to help us. You could help us, you know. Every $10 makes a difference. You could help us. So we're there. Where else? Sudan, right now. You have no idea what's happening. You have to get involved in my series on Sunday mornings on the battle of Gog of Magog, because what is happening, the horrendous, botched, unthinkable, unconscionable desertion from Afghanistan, leaving Americans behind enemy lines today, the State Department today. Today. Now, you talk about the blind leading the blind. Today, do you know what our State Department announced? They were just totally surprised that when the Taliban formed their government, this is a terrorist organization, formed a government, do you know what our government was concerned about? They said, oh my, the Taliban has formed their government and they didn't put any women in the government. That's what we're concerned about. We've got American school children being held at gunpoint on airplanes trying to get out of that nation. And our State Department is concerned that when a terrorist organization formed their government, they didn't put any women or people of other ethnicities on the government. Hello? Is anybody home at all in Washington, D.C.? Is anybody home? People are falling from airplanes to their death. Leave it alone. To their death. And we're concerned about a terrorist story. Who in the world would have expected the Taliban, the greatest women's rights abusers on earth? Where's the National Organization of Women? Where are they? Where are those women's rights? I thought that's what we cared about. Women are being caned. Women are being stoned. Women are not allowed to leave their home and take one step into the street without a male accompanying them. They can no longer go to school. They can no longer serve in the government. They can no longer let any part of their body be seen except their eyes. Where's the outcry? Have you noticed their silence is deafening? Nobody marching in the streets. Nobody stopping traffic. The news media has already put this on the 14th page because they don't want you to know about it. Wake up. Wake up. Get my series on Gog of Magog. Tune in and study. We are headed as fast as the unlocked wheels of time will carry us to the rapture of the church. I got three grunts. I said rapture. I said rapture. Somebody shout, even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus. When the world is dying and the moon is bleeding and the seas are seething under the whiplash of fury to spill their dead in the lap of God, there will be a group of us that will be winging our way into the celestial pavilions of the glory of God. Act like it. Tell everybody you know. So 10 days of awe. 10 days of circumspection, 10 days of introspection, 10 days of repentance, 10 days of examining ourselves. So let a man eat that bread. So let a man drink that cup of the Lord. After he has examined himself, so let a man examine himself. You critical spirit, precious saint that ain't, and your constant inspection of everybody else's fruit, examining the speck in your brother's eye and refusing to acknowledge the beam in your own. This is your time. This is your time to examine yourself. Search me, said the sweet psalmist of Israel, and see if there be any wicked way in me. Thy word, O God, have I hidden in my heart so that I could confess a new Mercedes. Thy word, O God, have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. Here's Samuel. God forbid that I should sin against him by failing to pray for myself. So you don't even know the scripture. God forbid that I should sin against God by failing to pray for you. Think about your last prayer session. How much of it was centered on you? And how much was it centered on anybody else but you? You say, well, now it's quiet. Well, this is what we're supposed to be doing. I'm sorry, preacher, who should have been a stand-up comedian instead of calling yourself an anointed man of God. God said these 10 days out of 365, would you quiet yourself? Job said, when I consider God, I fear him. We've lost the fear of God. We have lost reverence for the holy things of God. We have become so casually occupied. Everything's about fun. Everything's about dress down. Everything's about comb your hair with a wagon wheel, polish your shoes with a Hershey bar. Everything's about, you don't need to comb your hair. Just put a whirligig on the top of your head. Where's reverence? Dr. Lowe, what would your parents or pastor have done to you? When did you start playing the organ? 8? Earlier? 6? Very early. Did you ever run up on a platform and run around and throw toys? What would they have done to you? Oh, well, don't say it. Because I know what would happen to me. I'm not a legalist, but there's something to be said. Everybody loves it. I heard a preacher in North Carolina after I preached in Tennessee that made his entire Sunday morning service out of these two phrases. the language. Silence is the language of defeat. But shouting is the language of victory. But wait a minute. Running is the language of freedom. Shouting is the language of victory. Clapping, these are all biblical. I can give you chapter and verse for all of them. Clapping is the language of authority. I'm going to keep on trying. I said, I'm going to keep on trying. I wrote down right before I walked into that service of revival under the tent in Tennessee. Hands lifted up. Well, that's the language we all know of surrender. I preached that one. Dancing, I preached that one, is the language of what? Dancing is the language of joy. Spinning is the language of what? Warfare, shout it. Spinning is the language of warfare. Running is the language of freedom. Don't ever just say freedom. Y'all just say freedom. If you were ever chained to a tree, like the nearly 50,000 that we've set free in Sudan, beaten with sticks, have their left hand cut off if they confess Christ, have their left breast cut off if they're a woman that confesses Christ, chained to a tree, fed like a dog, beaten like an animal. And a United States Senator and a former Valor Christian College, Bible College graduate who was working in his office came off a truck, walked up to that tree, and took iron cutters and cut those chains off. They didn't sit there and say, thank you. They ran. So running is the language of. But wait, we're in the 10 days of awe. 10 days where our assignment is to be in awe of Him, to have His presence visit us personally and corporately in such a way that we dare not lift up our head. For the awe of His greatness and His power. We are talking about the third feast season of Israel. Somebody that studies their Bible, yell out the first feast season. Passover. What is the first feast in Passover? Oh boy. Oh boy. People beg me, well, some people beg me, can we not do the feast thing? It's some of the greatest revelatory preaching that God ever deposited in my spirit. Do you know why believers do not live in the center of the circumference of the perfect will of God? Do you know why? Because they don't know what time it is. You don't find the will of God, you what? You wake up in it. You live in it. In him we live, in him we move, in him we have our being. If we don't move in Jesus, we dare not move at all. We don't even know what time it is. I love preachers that walk around and show everybody their fake diamond bezeled Rolex. They're always showing off their timepiece. You know, people that have money don't act like they do. I don't drive something to impress somebody. I drive what I like. I can drive anything I want. God has been good to me. And they got, you know, their bishop ring full of genuine zirconia. I'm just playing with you. It's true, though. Hurtful, truthful. And they want to impress you with their timepiece. But regardless of how expensive it is, it's not correct. Because God does not rule his world and ours by a timepiece that counts 12 hours twice a day. No. You want to see a diamond bezeled timepiece. Tonight on the way home, or if you're watching on your phone right now, look up. That's God's timepiece. It's bedazzled with stars and planets and universes, overlapping universes, and great gaping black holes of nothingness. That's how God tells time. On not the Gregorian calendar, but on the lunar calendar, he set in the heavens the moon to keep time. The oceans and their waves and their, what do you call that? Where they, tides, are not ruled by ocean liners. They're ruled by the gravitational pull of the moon, which has no ability to shine. The moon is a reflector of the sun. You and I are not suns. We are stars that have no ability to shine on our own, but simply reflect the glory of our Father in the night sky, not in the day sky. In the darkness, not in the light. So there you have it. You have that first season, Passover. You got the Feast of First Fruits and the Feast of Unleavened Bread and the main feast of Passover for which the season is named. And then 50 days later, you move into another season. Now the seasons are set by the moon. God said, on this day, in this month, you shall do thus and so. Pentecost comes exactly 50 days after Passover. It is not only a feast season, but it is its own feast. If you think of the seven tiers of the candlestick, there are three on one side, three on the other side, and one that sticks higher than them all in the middle. That's Pentecost. That's what the church world has forgotten. That's our power. We got so-called Pentecostal churches following non-Pentecostal guidelines of church growth. You're not building a church, you're building an organization. In order to build his church, it is impossible without the power and the presence and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Then, there's a long separation. Long separation. So we have four feasts in two seasons within 50 days of each other in a 365-day year. And then way later, in the fall of the year, it begins the Feast of Tabernacles. Do you know that the first four feasts have all already been historically fulfilled? No, you don't, so I'll tell you. Everybody shout online. I need you to shout, because I had something entirely different planned for you tonight, but I am under the anointing of the Holy Spirit because I know what time it is. And I don't want you to be messed up. Watch. Ashton Blair was up here a moment ago. We have been blessed to live in the same home since her brother was born 31 years ago. That's a long time. We have three staircases that go to one floor and two that go to the other. Right in the middle, there are three staircases that converge from the upstairs. That's where the bedrooms are. Ashton was down there, and Austin was over there, and Joni and I were down there. My children are both proud graduates of the premier Christian school in the state of Ohio. It's called Harvest Preparatory School. Graduate more seniors at a higher academic level than any other Christian school. 100% graduation, 92% college acceptance. Find one. Every pastor in America ought to have a school. You're awfully silent. I thought I heard you amen online. Would you rather send them to where your third grader gets taught to go to the bathroom and see what sex they are, but then get told by their teacher you can't tell by that? Because we're following the science. Well, you're not following biology. Male and female created he them. There are two, count them, one, two sexes. Two. If you're confused, I can help you. No, like for real, I can help you. Because you don't have to live in that bondage. And you don't have to live by a lie. And you don't have to mutilate your body to try to be something you were never intended to be. Well, this is what happens. Then there's a long period of time. I've got about 8 minutes. There's a long period of time, a separation. Say a separation. So, quick, long time. Then suddenly. Watch. So when you get over here to the feast that has never been historically fulfilled. Passover was fulfilled at Calvary and the resurrection. Pentecost was fulfilled exactly 50 days later. When there appeared a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire that sat upon each of them. And they began to speak with other tongues as the Holy Spirit gave them utterance. That's a poor translation. It actually says where the Holy Spirit enabled them to express their original self. What's that? That's your spirit. So your body and your mind get turned off, and the Holy Ghost says, watch this, and speaks mysteries that you know not of by uttering in phrases that are not articulated in common speech. The only two gifts of the nine gifts of the Holy Spirit that transpired after the day of Pentecost that were never there before are the gift of tongues and interpretation of tongues. Think of that. God changed everything. Prophecy in the Old Covenant, healing in the Old Covenant, discerning of spirits in the Old Covenant, the gift of prophecy and miracles, healing, all in the Old Covenant. But not tongues and interpretation of tongues, which together equal prophecy. Why? God wanted us to know we weren't supposed to be lone rangers. Took two. You don't like teaching, do you? You want me to... First feast, Passover. Second feast, Pentecost. Long period of time, both of those fulfilled. You get over here to tabernacles. Tabernacles, does that mean anything to you? The tabernacle was the tent of meeting where God came to dwell among his people. This one, not yet fulfilled. Guess what the first of the three feasts inside the season of tabernacles is? Trumpets. Where's my trumpet? Give me my trumpet. I have this for something else, but I'll use it for this. Trumpets. 1 Thessalonians chapter number 4. I would not have you to be ignorant. It doesn't mean unintelligent. It means misinformed. I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those like my precious uncle, who I watched today, who served in the United States Navy, who has gone on, I said he served in the United States Navy. He laid his life on the line. He went on to heaven today, or a few days ago. Today, they brought him out with that coffin draped with a beautiful stars and stripes forever American flag draped over his deceased body. When they pulled that casket out, they had on their finest military uniforms. And the first thing they did was pick up a trumpet. I would not have you to be misinformed preachers of the 21st century. A wonderful thing should have happened to you in the third grade. You should have learned to read. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, I would not have you to be ignorant, misinformed, brethren, concerning those which are asleep, dead, that you sorrow not, even as others. Oh, look at them. I didn't know you had it. Sorrow not, grieve not, as though as others who have no what? Hope. Continue. Verse 14. For if we believe that Jesus died, anyone believe in the cross, anyone believe in the blood, anybody believe in his sacrifice, anybody believed in the Via Dolorosa, if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, God will bring with him those who have died. Continue. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, by prophecy, that we who are alive and remain, are you here? You're here right now. If you're dead, please notify someone. And remain until the coming of the Lord will not precede those who are asleep. Because the dead in Christ, the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the shouted trumpet call of God. The first feast in tabernacles, which is yet to be fulfilled, is the Feast of Trumpets. 100 blasts of the trumpet will signal his return. Are you listening? Separated. The Bible is fulfilled that says, haven't we said and heard from our fathers that Jesus was coming? So right after the first Passover and Pentecost, they were looking for him. 50th Passover and Pentecost, they were looking for him. 100 years after the Passover and Pentecost, they were looking. 1,000 years, they were still looking. 1,500 years, we are weary. We don't think he's ever coming again. 2,000 years. He's not coming. There's no reason to talk about heaven and hell. There's no reason to talk about eternity. There's no, just tell people to have their best life right now. It's all that matters. Modern church doctrine. I'm trying. Trumpets. Rosh Hashanah. Beginning of a new year. 10 days of all. Follow the bouncing preacher. 10 days of all. During this season, there are more earthquakes than any time of any year. There are more murders than at any time in any year. There are more natural disasters at any time in any year. The earth is in an upheaval. The entire creation groaning, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. Why? What are we about to memorialize again the 20th year anniversary of? How many of you were not even alive September 11th, 2001? Get every documentary you can find. It was a turning point in world history and in kingdom events. Something was loosed that has not been bound. 20 years. coast-to-coast aircraft hijacked in the middle of the air and flown into the Twin Towers in New York City. Some of you never knew a New York City with World Trade Center 1 and 2. Icons of American power, prosperity, and prowess around the world. And a bunch of terrorists murdered nearly 3,000 people. You don't remember. You weren't there. I watched live as hundreds of human beings out of the 70th floor leaping to their deaths and bouncing 20 feet off the ground when they hit. This is terrorism, not some political pawn. They hate us. They hate our way of life. They hate our freedom. They hate that our women walk around without a blanket over top of them. They hate that we educate you. They hate that we let you work. They hate that we have a vice president of the United States that is a woman, and we have had an African American man that was a president, and they hate us for it. We are the infidels. My children would descend those staircases. I'm almost finished. My children would descend those staircases every morning. And they did not present themselves before Miss Joni and I and put their hands out. Oh, Father. My Father. Father, 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 Father. Why do you say Father in Jesus 22 times in a 28-word prayer? Father, Father, Father. Jesus, Jesus. What doth iseth, thyeth willeth, foreth meeth, to death. They didn't do that. Why do you do that? Because they know what I would have said. I would have said, Ashton Blair, get your final self upstairs. Make your bed. Get your book bag with the homework done in it. Bring it back down here. Sit down at the table. Eat your breakfast, put your dish in the dishwasher. No. No. If you're a parent and you have people living in your home under 18, they your dishwasher. Oh, look at them. They don't want to clap on that. Got young girls come to Bible college, can't boil an egg. Got young men, can't make a bed. Can't mow a lawn. Young girls that can't iron a shirt. My children didn't do that. And the reason they didn't do that is they knew what time it was. It's school time. Now, if they'd have done that on Saturday, I'd have thought something was wrong with them. But that's what the church does. Saturday work on Sunday. We don't know what time it is. The only way for you to miss the will of God is to not know spiritually what time it is. The reason the entire earth is in upheaval during this season every single year is twofold. Because your Bible says Satan knows the scriptures better than you. He knows what I'm teaching you right now. And he knows that during tabernacle season, one of these years, Jesus is coming. So he gets very, very concerned. He tries to distract you. He tries to discourage you. He tries to bring all hell against you. He tries to prove that God is not God and Jesus is not alive and nobody likes you and everybody hates you. Because he knows if he can get you, he needs to get you right now. I don't know how many young ladies around are going to find out in the next weeks that they're with child. I don't know. Why? The enemy drives. He drives. I don't know how many husbands and wives are just going to knock down, drag out, lose their sanctification, and some of them lose their marriage. They don't know what time it is. Do you know why I brought up 9/11? It happened in this season. The withdrawal from Afghanistan and all the fallout this season. Hurricanes this season. Deaths this season. Jesus may come before I finish. I've always dreamed of the rapture happening while I was preaching. I'm not playing. What better way to go than between a hallelujah and a hallelujah and off I go. Somebody shout. You ought to be sharing this right now. You ought to be clicking on there right now. You ought to be giving thumbs up right now. You, when I watch this after the service, I better see 10 million clapping hands and praised hands and praying hands. The trump of God shall sound. The dead in Christ shall rise first. We which are alive and remain shall be caught up into the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we forever be with the Lord. Trumpets. 10 days of awe, and then the Day of Atonement. 10 days of introspection. 10 days of fasting. 10 days of prayer. 10 days of communion. 10 days of focusing on you. My precious wife, Joni, said the Bible says that a man or a woman should only leave their spouse in times to be before the Lord, not girl's day and guy's day. What you need is a Jesus day. 10 days. 10 days. People think I talk like this because I'm old. You should have heard me when I was 25. He's coming. And he says, take 10 days, examine yourself. And then, at the end of the 10 days, is the Day of Atonement. Here's what he's saying. No matter what you uncovered about yourself, on the Day of Atonement, the blood covers it all. Somebody just shout because you can. Shout, it's under the blood. So I want you to sign up for my 10 email teachings on the days of all. All I've done is pique your interest a little bit. Are you listening? They'll download. Just as soon as you give us your email address, and we will send them to you every single day. Amen? If you sign up, you receive yesterday's teaching as well. So you'll get yesterday's and today's right now. And so you're already a day behind, but you can get set, you can get caught up. Amen? I want to give you this because they're for the 10 days of all. So I gave you shouting is the language of victory and so forth. But before I walked on that platform, God said, what is kneeling? Oh, kneeling is the language of reverence. What is bowing? Bowing is the language of honor. Singing is the language of worship. And walking is the language of possession. If you can walk on it, you can have it. Write the name of something you need dominion over on a piece of paper and just walk on it. Just walk on it. And then get down on your face in holy reverence. Bow in great honor. Bring yourself into the presence of the Almighty. Somebody just wave him a praise right now. Wave him a praise right now. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, I feel his mighty presence. Dr. Lowe, I just feel him. I feel Jesus in this place. Thank you. Worship him just for a moment. Would you just for a moment? I feel Jesus. He's in this place. Yes, 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 yes.
I feel Jesus in this place.
Bless you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus. Yeah. Ah. We just entered the new year. God's new year. This is it. We're not even 24 hours into it. It's the Hebrew year 5782. I've been waiting on it for 7 years. Because it's a Shemitah year. It's a year of double pregnancy. A double Adar. A double double. A Shemitah year only comes one time every 7 year cycle. This is it. This is your year. I don't care what 2020 looked like. I don't care what 2022 looked like. We are in a brand new year, and God said it's a double portion pregnancy year. You're about to give birth to twice as much as you ever thought you could. Glory.
Glory to God.
I said glory.
Glory.
I said glory.
Glory.
I said glory. You can be seated. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to get out a seed. Why? Well, because your Bible says that you rob me in tithe and offering. Tithe is 10% of the sanctified gross income. It comes every time you receive increase. But that's not what I'm talking about tonight. I'm talking about the three commanded offerings of God. Commanded, not suggested. God said at Passover, at Pentecost, and in the fall of the year at Tabernacles, come before me. And as plain as black ink can be on white pages, he says, do not come before me without an offering in your hand. Three times a year, a God-ordained special anointing on your offering seat. I need my product, please. Is it up? Oh, thank you so much. Look what I've got for you. Look what I've got for you. Unbelievable. For your gift tonight of any size, I'm going to send you seven anointings of the Day of Atonement. What are they? How do you walk in them? How do I receive them? It's also got the DVD in the back of it. I'm going to send it all to you as you sow a seed during this season of any size. They are, here are the blessings. How to receive the double portion anointing. How to receive restoration of anything that has been broken. How to receive special miracles. How to receive the presence of God. How to receive a blessing on your family. How to receive deliverance from every bondage. And the last one, how to receive the financial breakthrough you're praying for. They're all in the atonement. And I share that with you. I'm going to send that to everybody that sows tonight. And then here's what I wish I could take about the next 14 weeks and teach you. It's called Fulfilling the Feast, Celestial Clues to God's Divine Calendar. Six messages. First one, Red Blood Moon. Most of you don't even know what it is. You don't know when it occurs. You don't know what it means. You don't know the historical perspective. You don't know the biblical reality and revelation. Red Blood Moon, fact or fiction? Second one, God's Calendar, Celestial Clues to the Culmination of All Creation. Number three, boy, I love this one. The Magnetic Vacuum of Divine Withdrawal. The Rosh Hashanah reality. During the next 10 days, God will feel as though he has withdrawn from you. If some of you girls had ever learned that and quit chasing boys, he didn't text me 14 times today. You needy little thing, you. No guy wants a girl like that. Take your fine self away from him for a while. See if he'll pay the price to chase you.
That's good.
That's what God does. He literally withdraws to see how desperate you are for him. Wow. Number five, God's season, your seven blessings. Six, the Day of Atonement, the Kfar connection. I'm telling you, I've only taught it one time in 43 years. It is a treasure trove. Get it. Now wait, because that's not all. For everybody that sows a $1,000 or more seed, I'm talking to at least five of you right now, I'm going to send you from the Holy Land, directly from Israel, this beautiful silver trumpet. I think we even send you the thing to hang it on the wall. And people will say, what is that? And you say, well, that's the trumpet I'm going to respond with when I hear the trumpet of Jesus coming in the air. Are you ready to go to heaven? So tonight, Father, bless everyone. Lord, let them have this reality. Let them live it. Let them seek your face. Say to us, oh God, seek my face, that we may respond, thy face, oh God, will I seek. Amen. Amen. Those of you online, we love you so very, very, very much. And we'll see you live tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock from right here, Valor Christian College Chapel. And then on Sunday morning, I'll be preaching right up in this pulpit. Tell all your friends, share about it, and let's have the greatest Sunday we ever had. I love you. So you see, you're commanded. Tabernacles offering. We love you. Sowing into the mighty kingdom of God has never been easier or more secure than with Smart Giving. Any smartphone will work. To use your Smart Giving, open your text messaging app and send a text to the number 45777. In the message of your text, type the amount of your gift, space WHC. If it's your first time using Smart Giving, you'll receive a secure link to set up your account. Select your home campus and enter your giving method and where you would like your giving receipt sent. If you're already registered, the process is the same. Just send a text message to 45777, type the amount of your gift, space WHC, and you'll receive your receipt immediately. Now, if you'd prefer, you can also sow online at whc.life or by phone or by mail. Just call the number on your screen or send your gift to the address.
Say Listen. Such goodness, such mercy, your faithfulness pursues me. Such friendship, such blessing, your grace is all consuming. Yeah. Such goodness, such mercy, your faithfulness pursues me. Such friendship, such blessing.